Does vaping cause cancer? Vaping has quickly become a common habit, often with the idea that it's risk-free. But is that really the case? Today, let's dive into this critical question to understand the potential health risks of vaping. Unlike traditional cigarettes, e-cigarettes don't contain tobacco and don't produce combustion smoke. Vaping involves inhaling an aerosol produced by an e-cigarette. This aerosol typically contains nicotine, flavors, and other chemicals such as propylene glycol, vegetable glycerin, nitrosamines, formaldehyde, acrolein, heavy metals. Some of these substances are potentially harmful, like formaldehyde and acrolein, which are known carcinogens. A published study found significant levels of heavy metals, such as nickel and lead, in the aerosols of some e-cigarettes. While some studies suggest that vaping could reduce risks compared to traditional smoking, it's not without dangers. A study published in Tobacco Control in 2018 showed that lung cells exposed to vaping aerosols exhibited cellular and DNA damage. Additionally, e-cigarettes have been observed to cause inflammatory responses in lung cells, similar to those seen in cigarette smokers. The vapor from e-cigarettes can induce DNA mutations in mouth and lung cells, which could potentially lead to cancer in the long term. Traditional smoking is well documented as a major cause of cancer. According to the World Health Organization, tobacco is responsible for over 8 million deaths annually. Vaping might be less dangerous than smoking, but that doesn't mean it's safe. Before we continue, please subscribe, like the video, and drop a comment, even just a quick hello. It's the best way to support our work. A study comparing levels of harmful substances in the blood and urine of smokers and vapers found that vapers had significantly lower levels of carcinogens. However, it's crucial to note that less dangerous does not mean safe. So, does vaping cause cancer? The answer isn't straightforward. Public health agencies like the WHO and the FDA recommend caution with e-cigarettes due to the existing risks. If you're a non-smoker, it's better not to start vaping. If you smoke, consult a healthcare professional to discuss the best options for quitting smoking. Have you tried vaping? Are you thinking of quitting soon? Share your thoughts in the comments. Subscribe, like the video, and support us on Patreon for just $1 a month if you enjoy our work. And above all, stay curious